That's like a pre-interview BO test.
All right.
I'm sitting here with Brian Schwab. This is for Elite Fitness Systems, EliteFTS.com. I'm Jim Lindler. It is the day after the 2008 IPA Pro-Am in January, was it the 20th? 20th, 2008. So Brian had a spectacular meet. He competed for possibly the last time at 148 pounds. I know that's a huge cut for you. I don't know if you guys can tell, but Brian's one thick son of a bitch over here.
Thanks, Jim.
Possibly one of these, Dave. See, now I have to hold up my hand every time I fuck up, so that might be one right there. Brian squatted 765, which is?
Five times body weight.
Five times body weight. To put in perspective, that means it's basically like a 2,000 or 1,000-pound squat for a 200-pound guy, which is absolutely amazing. 565 bench and a 600-pound deadlift. For a 1930 total, which gave him an 85-pound increase since the last time he competed at 148. We're gonna go real quick on how you cut the weight. You started off at what weight?
Usually between 160 and 165.
Okay.
I start cutting my carbs just about a week or so out.
Okay.
I used to start further out, but I found that it would drain my strength too much and dehydrate me slightly, so make me more likely to get injured during the training cycle, so I wait till I'm done training. Cut my carbs and then wait till basically the last 24 hours to dehydrate myself.
With, you know, hot tub, sauna.
Hot tub, sauna.
Stuff like that.
Yeah.
That's it may not seem pounds-wise, the percentage of weight, it's insane.
Yeah.
You really kind of break it down because you're at a lower body weight, so. And, but you managed to put everything back on?
Yeah.
How was your energy during the meet?
Felt fine.
Okay. What did you do eating-wise after you?
I usually drink either Gatorade Endurance or Pedialyte and
okay.
Penta water, which is the...
It's like pentagram water? All right, yeah. It's got like goat's blood in there,
yes,
and virgin's
yes.
blood. Some menzies from the virgins. That's... periods.
Yeah, that's good.
Okay. Okay. So you drink a lot of basically just trying
just
to get to
rehydrate.
What about food? Do you anything
different? High sodium food.
Okay.
I ate a lot of the ramen noodles actually this time.
Like college?
Yeah. Cheap food.
Yeah. That's my problem. Oh man. I almost said something bad. That would have been that would have gotten me fired big time. They would have had to fire me on that one. Okay, you know, we mentioned you had obviously a great meet, 85-pound increase at your level is huge, huge, because as we know, even a 5-pound increase, or even if you have a 10-pound decrease, it's still, you know, you're still doing okay, right? It's kind of nuts. So give me a couple things that you did, maybe for your squat, because obviously your squat was insane. Or maybe there's not something you didn't really do, maybe just...
I think I just basically timed my training a little better this time.
Okay.
I actually do... although it's a little bit unusual for powerlifters, but I actually do plan my training based off of a specific max.
Kind of a goal.
Yeah, I actually have a goal, and I actually figured out a spreadsheet that gives me a percentage to go off of each week to train.
Okay.
And I basically cycle through using a high box, parallel box, then full squat. So each week I do a different level of the squat based on a different percentage. And I just, everything worked out better this time. Even though they were pretty strict on the depth, it worked out fine.
That was pretty, just so people understand, that judging that was pretty brutal. I mean, very brutal. Probably the best I've ever seen. Of course, you know, I was mid an IPA meet, so that's not really saying anything. Take it out! Re-rack it! 565. Now, you've obviously had some great days benching. You benched, what is it,
600
and 165. And obviously, the cut about 565 is still incredibly, you know, insane. How did you do anything? I know you do bench off boards. A lot of people
shirted board training every week.
I'm gonna guess you do it because it doesn't tear you up as bad. It
doesn't beat up my shoulders.
Yeah.
As much.
Okay. And how do you feel getting down to the chest at a meet when you don't do it?
I never have an issue with that. I basically know how much weight it's gonna take to touch. I know the technique that I need to bring it lower onto my belly, and I never have an issue with that.
Okay, now I was at your last meet in was it it Jacksonville?
Yes.
Jacksonville, and Brian had a tremendous meet all the way up into the deadlift. He had some grip problems. And to make a long story short, he addressed these grip problems at this meet. And it's kind of a, when I saw you, everyone thought Brian had hurt his hand, but tell him what you did to get rid of kind of a, make sure your hands weren't bloated at all from carving up.
I actually submerged my hands in ice and just alternated each hand just for a few minutes.
Okay.
And that brought the swelling down enough to.
So basically, Brian had some bloat on the fingers, stuck his hand basically in the, it was the, we're at the Marriott, right?
Yes.
It was their ice buckets. He just stuck it in there and got rid of the bloat a little bit. So, did you do anything for recovery, or did you actually feel like you trained smarter this time?
I think.
Or was it just one of those things?
Just everything worked out well this time.
Okay.
Didn't really change my training too much. It just seemed like.
How about your elbows? Did it give you any problems or anything?
No.
Okay.
Yeah, my elbows were bothering me for a little while, yeah. But that's. I do forearm rotation, which seems to help reduce the, increases the strength of the tendons.
So you do like a lot of this?
I do a lot of that. A lot of that. I alternate.
Yeah. I do like this. I have a midget climb up, try on the top, and slide down. It's got a ladder, but you know, the stronger ones can climb up on their own. Right. Two revolutions, kids. Two revolutions. Okay, you got a video coming out. Is that right?
Yes, I have a bench press training video coming out, hopefully around the end of March.
Okay. And what is this going to cover?
It's going to cover my specific training. Instead of using a dynamic effort bench day, I do a raw bench day on boards. And I only do the dynamic effort once every 3 weeks.
Okay.
I only use chains for the accommodating resistance when I do my dynamic effort.
No bands.
No bands, just because they tend to beat up my shoulders and elbows too much.
Okay.
And just like with the squat training, I base my bench training off of a projected max.
Okay. So everything's very planned out for you?
Very planned out.
Okay. Well, that'd be kind of cool for people to see. And hopefully it'll be out, what, in March, you said?
Hopefully in March.
Obviously, you could sell it through us.
Yes.
Okay.
Definitely.
Sell his, do you have a name for the video yet?
Sorry. What do you think?
We were saying 12 weeks.
Yeah, 12 weeks to a bigger bench.
Okay.
Specifically for a three month.
How to get a bigger cock. And then, whoops, this is the bench press one.
Bench.
That one's going to, yeah, I don't care. You can edit. Actually, there's nothing, I don't care. Dave, you don't have to edit anything. Dave edits these things, but he never actually watches them, so we could say all kinds of swear words, and then you'd never know. And just go up on his company's website, which is whatever. All right, this is Brian Schwab. Congratulations, Brian.
Thanks, Tim.
Thank you for being part of the team.
Sure.
Always a good time. Lovely wife, Trinity, over there. She's not on camera, but she makes all the decisions in the house.
She speaks.
And she's wonderful, supportive, wonderfully supportive of Brian's lifting and everything else. And a fantastic driver. Yeah. Why don't you drive a lot, Brian?
Because I like to drink.
<That's good. laughs>
I don't have a problem.
I know I drink, so. Yeah. Oh, well. All right, we're done. Thanks, man. Appreciate it.